Hello everybody, Mobius One here, bringing you the first episode of a new series on the channel. This is Star Wars Battlefront 2 Classic. And quite obviously, just like the last couple of series that I've been doing, Shadows of the Empire and Battlefront 1 Classic, I am not going to be muting the copyrighted music in this series because, come on, with classic games such as this, they deserve the full experience. They deserve the music from the films. They deserve everything, honestly, because these are the games from the quote-unquote golden era of Star Wars games from LucasArts. So I'm going to be eating the copyright claims, and I'll obviously be reminding you guys throughout the series. Sorry in advance. But, yeah, I'm not going to be earning any ad revenue off this series, which I know you guys are going to enjoy it. Please, if you want to show your support for the channel, visit my Patreon link in the video description. I have options for only $1 a month, which more than covers any of the lost ad revenue that I would otherwise make by muting the music. But just listen to it. It's glorious already. I don't want to spend too much time blabbering, but if you have not, for whatever reason, ever played this game before, you gotta let me know in the comments. Say something, let me know that this is the first time you're going to be experiencing this game, because this is, man, I don't even know how to describe it. The campaign in this game is actually really, really good and quite dark. This is one of the best, in my opinion, Star Wars campaigns from the early 2000s. And, you know, we can talk about how Disney got, you know, manipulated the canon or whatever with all the Legends material, whatever, but this is still a really solid Legends story, which I think a lot of us probably still consider canon at the end of the day anyway. The last thing I want to point out is that all of the menus in this game are 4:3 aspect ratio, which is why I've got the black bars on the sides of the video. Once we get into the actual gameplay, it will become 1920x1080 resolution. But yeah, I've looked at a couple of mods or a couple of different ways to manipulate the aspect ratio, and they do exist, but they kind of break other things, like the menu button placement and everything. So instead of messing up, like trying to fix certain things and messing up other things, we're just going to leave it vanilla. So I'm not running any mods. We're going to be doing a lot. We're going to start off with training, because the training actually has some story in it. We're going to skip the space overview, which, yes, this game has space battles, and then we're going to start a new campaign. We'll try and do 2 to 3 missions per episode, depending on how long they are. So let's jump right in with training.
My first day as a member of the 501st. It was hot, it was sandy, chaotic. Nothing at all like the simulations on Kamino. Of course, that's pretty much the way it was for all of us, wasn't it? All that breeding, all those years of training, it doesn't really prepare you for all the screaming or the blood, does it? Frankly, I'm still amazed we ever made it through the first hour. Never mind the first day.
Alright, so I'm going to see if I can manipulate the audio there. That seemed a little bit quiet, but yes, that was Tamara Morrison, the actor who played Jango Fett, and Boba Fett in The Mandalorian. Voicing the clones. So, here we go. We can only spawn as a clone trooper. We're on Geonosis. Let's do it.
Your simulation days are over, trooper. This is a real battle. And if you mess up, you'll really end up in a world of pain. Now get out there.
All right, so you can see it's very similar.
Reported in the vicinity of Checkpoint Alpha. Get there and secure the area.
Text is really small in this resolution, but I'll read it. Follow the yellow objective arrow to Checkpoint Alpha. Alright, so that's where we're going. So let me real quick check the volume. Oh, this is why. Master volume down to 50%. Alright, we'll try that. And do we have subtitles? Oh, they are on. I guess just not for training. Okay. So, yes. So, pretty much the gameplay is exactly the same as the first game, except now we have a couple additional features. So in the bottom left, you can see my primary weapon. I have a secondary weapon, grenades or thermal detonators. I don't have anything else. I can now jump while strafing, and I can roll forward as well as roll to the side. The blue bar on the bottom left is my health, and the yellow bar is like my stamina. So jumping and rolling affects stamina, and I can now sprint, which drains stamina. So with that out of the way, let's get going.
Droid scouts have been detected in the area. Take them out before they can report our position.
Alright, so this is just going to give me all the controls as if I've never played the game before. So we won't read everything. Ah, so with the crosshair now, you can see when I shoot, there's these little hash marks that appear around the inside of the crosshair. That's my ammo. So you can see when I reload, those reappear. And we now have hit markers, which I think the last game had a hit marker too, but now that hit marker there is a hit. And there's a hashed hit marker. That right there is a headshot or a critical hit.
Nice work, clone. Let's hope those scouts didn't get word back to their army. Now,
I'm sure they did.
Finish off that damaged Hellfire droid using your thermal detonators.
So in the first game, the standard infantry had thermal detonators as well as concussion grenades, and the concussion grenades would stick to vehicles and do more damage. In this game, the thermal detonators do exactly the same thing, so they just simplified it.
Good job, but the droid army is headed this way. Capture the downed Techno Union ship to secure a stronger foothold for our troops.
Okay, so I mean, this is a really good tutorial for someone who's never played Battlefront before, or if they didn't play the first one. Oh look, droids are spawning. Alright, so same concept here. We capture the spawn point.
Go to the downed Techno Union ship and switch to the engineer class at the command post there.
Now this is something that we couldn't do in the last game. You can go to one of your command posts now, press a button, and change classes without dying.
Good. Now use your fusion cutter to repair the health and ammo droid.
Alright, so we very rarely play as the engineer in our Battlefront 1 playthrough because their weapon was terrible. But in this game, instead of that weird lightning cannon, we get a shotgun, which is actually pretty effective. So we might play as this class a couple more times. Just like the first game, we've got the medical droid that will heal us when you're standing near it. And the gonk droid, which is the ammo droid.
Nice work, trooper. Have sent in a column of spider walkers. Get to the ATTE clone and make it fast.
All right, so we get to do some vehicle combat. Here we go.
Now take one of those walkers down before they do some serious damage.
Unfortunately, you can't go first person in the ground vehicles. You can still zoom in. But like in the first game, we were able to go into the cockpit of the ATTE. We can't do that in this game. What we can do, though, is kind of walk and strafe at the same time. You can also see our overheat meter on the inside of the crosshair. They did a real good job simplifying the UI so that you don't have to constantly look up in the corner and see, like, your target's health. So now we can see our target's health at the top of the screen. There's the famous line.
The Inertian got killed and dropped a holocron on top of the Techno Union ship. Use a command post to switch to the Jet Trooper class.
Okay. Ooh. Alright, well, I guess we don't have to use a command post. We got killed. We got the Jet Trooper.
Now use your jump jets to get up there and acquire that holocron and bring it back to Checkpoint Alpha.
Acquire the Sith holocron. You'll need to... Yep, okay, so it's teaching us how to fly. So this is just like the Jet Trooper in Battlefront 1. Here's the holocron. You can see it actually there on our belt. Now, for whatever reason, when you're carrying this, you can't fly. You can see the icon on the right-hand side of the screen as I'm carrying, like, a flag. There'll be different times in the campaign where we'll be carrying objectives like this.
The CIS are holed up in the cliff bunker. Get up there. Take over that post. It will give us a strong vantage point on the battlefield.
Okay, so we gotta get up there and claim that command post. The Jet Trooper in this game is just as OP as it was on the first game. Because we have a pistol that can fire super fast. It overheats super quickly, but it also cools down pretty quickly. Alright, let's get up there. We can't really do much against these guys. Ooh, that wrist rocket! I should have watched it. Alright, give me some more interesting music. This is boring. Come on. I played through this before I recorded to like make sure all my settings were configured correctly, and the music was so epic. Anyway. Alright, so we're going to capture this command post. You can see the progress on the right-hand side of the screen, just above my head.
We need some snipers to pick off some droids and help thin out the CIS forces. Grab a sniper rifle and take out some droids.
Okay. One thing they changed, when you're playing the sniper class, you do not have a crosshair, so no scoping as a sniper is very difficult in this game. But it is possible. Ooh! I got shot in the back when I spawned in the wrong place. Actually, I don't think it matters. Okay, good.
Walkers are tearing us to ribbons. Get to a CP and switch to the heavy trooper class.
All right, now we change to the heavy trooper. Again,
now
works.
Take your rocket launcher and give one of those spiders a taste of some heavy fire.
Pretty much exactly the same way it worked in the first game. Oh, except for whatever reason. Crosshair aims a little low, so you have to aim lower than the target.
Master Windu has arrived on the battlefield. A lightsaber will come in handy against these droids. Let's knock down the CIS reinforcements a bit.
All right, so every once in a while you'll unlock a hero, and then you don't even have to. Playing as the heroes are totally optional, except I think in this training I think we actually do have to play as Mace Windu here. So I want to finish off that tank, and then we'll press F1, and we come in as Mace freaking Windu. I mean, remember the first game had hero units, but you couldn't play as them. They were pretty much just there to support you. This game, they were like, screw that. We're gonna let heroes be playable, and it's freaking epic. This really isn't doing all that much damage. Plus, it's not even our objective, but I don't care. Oh crap, the droid got in the tank.
We have to push the CIS back. Take over their bunker to the north.
So the way health works for the heroes, the health is actually that blue lightsaber on the bottom left. And as we get hit, obviously the lightsaber gets shorter. But by killing enemies, we actually gain health back. So it encourages you to play rather aggressively as a hero. Also, the health drains slowly over time. So you can't just like hide in a corner as a hero and stay hero all day because you'll eventually die. But playing aggressive, as long as you don't take too much damage, you'll end up healing yourself with every kill.
May the force be with you.
I think that's the end, right? Yeah, okay. So that's training. I think we're going to get an outro cutscene here with Tamara Morrison. Yep.
Incredibly, the 501st survived the Crucible of Geonosis, emerging battle-hardened and ready for whatever the war would throw at us.
Okay. Begun. The Clone War has. So, we're going to start up a new campaign. Here we go. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Man, I haven't played this in years. And of course, not muted main theme. Goodbye, ad revenue. All right. So, Star Wars Battlefront 2, Fall of the Republic. Shadow looms over the Republic. The Clone Wars have torn a rift across the galaxy, its populace weak in allegiance and resolve. Supreme Chancellor Palpatine has commissioned an elite division of clone troopers, the 501st Legion, to vanquish the Separatist threat once and for all. Their unwavering loyalty to the Chancellor, combined with the Republic's desperation to see an end to the war, has set the stage for the execution of Palpatine's ultimate plan. Yeah, I think I know what that is. Braving the frigid world of Mygeeto, the 501st joins Jedi Master Ki-Adi Mundi for the first of many crucial battles destined to shape the fate of the galaxy. So this is cool. We're going to actually play a lot of the scenes that we saw very short glimpses of in Revenge of the Sith in the Order 66 montage. So one of those scenes was Ki-Adi Mundi on Mygeeto, and here we are. So Mygeeto, amongst the ruins, a powerful energy source must be acquired from the CIS manufacturing plant. Okay.
In the waning months of the Clone Wars, the 501st faced missions critical to the agenda of Chancellor Palpatine. When we arrived at the bombed-out ruins of Mygeeto, our Jedi commander believed we had been sent to take out a droid energy collector. What Ki-Adi Mundi didn't know, however, was that our unit of the 501st was really after an experimental Mygeetan power source that the Chancellor wanted for his super laser. Keeping Mundi in the dark wasn't easy. The Jedi had become increasingly wary of the Chancellor's doings, and were on the lookout for the slightest hint of treachery. Just like the rest of them, though, he never caught whiff of what was really going on until it was far too late.
Dude, see, like, this game already has such a dark tone. All right, so very similar to the first game. We choose our class, which I love how the look of the troopers actually changes depending on what planet we're on. But we now have these special reinforcement units, the Clone Commander and the Jet Trooper, which you can't choose until you have enough points. There's also a maximum number allowed per team at a time. So we're just gonna spawn in as a regular clone right now, and we'll eventually unlock the other ones.
All right, men. Today's target is an energy collector on the northern section of the platform. If we can take it down, production facilities in the area will grind to a halt. Let's move them out. The enemy's forward command post is on the other side of this bridge. We'll have to capture it before moving on.
All right. Let's jump in that AT-RT.
Let's turn this place into a scrap pile.
Hey, up there. Okay. I don't want to overheat my lasers. We gotta take out the anti-vehicle droids. That's gonna hurt. I'm I'm not sure what's to my left or to my right. I'm just marching on the command post. Oh, there's a bunch of droids in there to the left. Oops. That was a team kill. March. Okay, we need to capture this, though. Alright, I'm hopping off. Can't capture command posts while in a vehicle. Somebody's coming. Take out the particle cannon turrets. Okay. I think I was actually shooting at one of them already. Yep. Ooh. So we do have a grenade launcher.
One more to go.
Nailed it.
The shield barricade. Get behind the shield and take out the generator.
I can actually play as Keanu Mundi now. Let's do it. Oh, tank. There we go. Okay. There we go.
CP will serve as an excellent lookout point for our mission.
Capture, oh, this one? Okay. Ooh! So luckily, you can't capture command points while in a vehicle, but you can totally capture them as a Jedi. Okay. Oh, right. Tanks. Well, ooh, that was a freaking jet trooper, not a battle droid. Turrets. Do I have to take out this one, too? No, I don't think I do, but let's do it anyway. Okay. Oh, that's the one I need at the end of the bridge.
Take down the course.
Leading the way.
The generator.
Copy that. Keep up the assault. Watch your flank. Friendly fire. They're coming around.
It's so difficult to time that jump. Oh, here we go. We gotta get up. Up here, right? Do we take this out? Or no. I can't go through this, can I? Yeah, no. Oh, wait. Is that right? I just break this.
Good work. Now collect the core samples and return them to the dropship on the other side of the bridge.
Okay. Can I carry this as a Jedi? Oh, I can. Easy. Come on, we just gotta get this back to the beginning. It's almost too easy as a Jedi. That's another example of, I know I said this a lot. Oh, crap, droidicas.
Sir, I can see the dropship.
I could just run for... Oh my god. I could probably just run for it, but... Let's have some fun here, shall we? Nailed it.
Nicely done, gentlemen. Your work here today has made the Chancellor a very happy man.
Done.
The success of the mission on Megiddo was something of a revelation for the men of the 501st. Suddenly, we realized that the Jedi could be fooled. And if they could be fooled, they could be killed.
Damn. All right. That was the end of the first mission, and we're already looking at this episode's already over a half hour. So we're going to end that right there. If I click done, I think this goes into the cutscene for the next mission. Oh no, it doesn't. Good. Excellent. They learned from the first game. So I can save. We'll save this as YouTube 1. And there we go. Coruscant, a desperate rescue. You know what? I'm going to treat you guys. Since this is the first episode of the series, we'll do one extra mission because this mission... Ooh, excuse me. This mission... is our first space mission. And what's cool is the game gives you the option to bypass space in case you don't like flying. But we like flying here on Mobius One's YouTube channel. So we're going to choose to attack. Sorry, I want to end this video, but I don't because this is going to be cool.
As Clone Wars progressed, more and more ground-based legions found themselves pressed into space combat, including the fighting forces of the 501st. For months, every hour of our downtime was spent in the simulator, preparing for the time we would face our enemies from the cockpit of a 170. Finally, the day came to earn our wings. The CIS had staged a daring kidnapping of Chancellor Palpatine and was being escorted from Coruscant by a fleet of separatist ships. With only a few veteran pilots on planet, many of the 501st were pressed into service to drive off the Seps. And buy time for a pair of Jedi Knights to rescue the Chancellor.
Okay, so this is literally the opening of Star Wars Episode 3.
Bomber incoming. Repeat, bomber incoming.
We're gonna load in
pilots
as a pilot.
Marines, get to your ships. The Jedi are depending on you.
Now, there are a lot of cool things you can do in this. You can actually... Well, actually, I don't know if this mission allows you to do all the other stuff. We'll just see what the actual game wants us to do.
Incoming fighters, take them out.
Okay, so take out the fighters first. Do I need to invert this? No, I think this is good. Okay. No, actually, I do think I need... No, it is inverted. I need it not inverted because I'm using the mouse. Invert, no. Yes, okay, that's better. Alright, so to start off, we just need to take out some fighters. We can do all kinds of maneuvers to avoid fire. We can roll. I'm sorry, grillers. We're going to be doing some crazy maneuvers in this. So if anybody gets motion sickness, I apologize in advance. You probably will not want to watch these episodes. That doesn't look like I'm doing any damage to that. You can do 180s to get people off your tail. Can even lock on and fire torpedoes.
Take out that bomber. Ship acting as a frigate for the droids. Destroy it.
Right. Okay, so now we can destroy that ship. Ooh, except we got blown up. Similarly to how when you're on the ground, if you're playing as an engineer, you automatically repair vehicles as you're driving them. In this, you will automatically repair your starfighter as long as you're a pilot. We also have a boost. I forgot about that, so let's use that. Okay, so we have to take out that Banking Clan frigate, but we got somebody on us.
Take out that fighter.
Got it.
Pilots, focus your fire on the main CIS ships. We need their shields down as quickly as possible.
Okay. I think he wants this one. Yep, okay, so we're gonna just shoot at this ship until its shields go down. We can focus on some of the hard points, like the turrets. So we got the shields. We can take out some of the turrets. Check out the communications array.
Now that they're in disarray, fly into their hangar and land. Be careful.
Okay, so they are going to have us do all the different things that you can do just to kind of showcase what your options in space are. So, while the pilot is obviously the right class to play if you're gonna fly around and fight in a fighter, the other option is to spawn as a Marine. And the reason you might wanna do that is because you can also board the enemy starship, as we're about to do, and fight inside. And when you do this,
rockets or time bombs to destroy the internal systems.
The pilot doesn't have a very good weapon. We just have a pistol. However, we do have time bombs. So instead of fighting the battle outside, ooh, hello. Oh shoot, there's turrets too. I forgot about that. Let this thing heal me up. Got it, okay. So there's different rooms here. I think this is the engine room. That aura we just got, I think, is a heal over time. Anyway, so we're gonna use our time bombs here. Oh crap, come on. Oh, hello. This should be enough to destroy it. It was also our last time bomb. Okay.
Grab a fighter and destroy the bridge of the enemy cruiser.
So we could continue to do damage to the ship from inside. Can we take one of their ships? Am I actually going to be able to... Can I actually pilot a vulture droid? That's gonna be kind of silly. Oh my god, I can. That's kind of ridiculous. Anyway, let's ignore the fact that this is a thing. And Let's take out the bridge.
Well done, gents. With flying like that, the Republic is well on its way to victory.
And that's it. Space battles in this game, A plus, super fun, probably the most fun
after disabling the final
in the game.
Ship, General Kenobi and Skywalker took advantage of the opportunity we'd created and rescued the Chancellor. Took all the credit too.
Oh, and some salty clones. All right, we're going to end this episode here. The next episode is... Well, here, let's save that. Felucia, Heart of Darkness. All right. Can I back out? Look at that. They learned. Continue without saving because we just saved. And we're back to the menu. We don't have to load the mission to return to the menu. Such an improvement over the first game. But yes, that's going to be it for the first episode of the series. Really, really good game. Really excited to be playing this again. I, for whatever reason, always, like, this game, I don't know. I thought it wasn't as good as the first Battlefront Classic recently, for whatever reason. But having reinstalled it and having jumped back into it, man, I'm super excited for it. It's been a really, really long time since I played it, and it feels good to be playing it again. So let me know in the comments if you guys have never seen this campaign before, because I love knowing if I'm exposing new things to people. And don't forget to check out the Patreon link in the video description. It really helps helps me put out more content like this without feeling bad for not muting the music. Because, yeah, it's just such a better experience being able to actually hear the Star Wars music. But yeah, I am spending time recording and making these videos for you guys, so I appreciate the support. Anyway, that's it for now. Mobius1 here. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.